Well, your autism is clearly mild.
I'm not a fucking hot sauce.
Man, my foot is killing me. Oh, yeah, last year I pulled a muscle in my foot. It sucked. Okay, I've been noticing this for a while, but why do you relay everything that I say back to yourself? It comes across as really self-centered. Shoot, I'm sorry. I know it may seem that way, but in reality, it's actually my way of trying to show you that I'm engaged in the conversation and I care about what you're saying. Oh, really? For some reason, the best way for me to process new information is to tether it to something that I've already experienced. Oh, so by relating what I'm saying to your experiences, you're trying to communicate that you understand what I'm feeling and you empathize with it. Yes, exactly. That. Got it. So you're not trying to actually draw the focus of the conversation to what you're saying, you're just being a really active listener. I think that's a pretty good way to put it.
Your flaws just died. Plant new seeds in the melody. Let me inside. I wanna get to know you. I don't wanna make you feel bad, but I hard not to act the fool. Sunflower, sunflower, sunflower. I could be watching you anymore. Kiss in the kitchen like it's a dance floor. I could be watching you anymore tonight.
How come it's okay for your friends to go to you with their problems, but you feel like it's not okay for you to do the same? Why is it that your friends are being strong and brave when they're vulnerable, but you feel like you're being weak and overly sensitive? When your friends open up to you, you see it as a way to genuinely connect. But when you open up to them, it feels like you're a burden to deal with. Believe that the lovely experience you're having when your friends talk about their struggles and confide in you is the same feeling they're having when you do it as well.
Hi, I'm Jake Gyllenhaal, and I'm hosting SNL this week with Camila Cabello.
No, Gyllenhaal. Your name is pronounced Gyllenhaal.
I guarantee you it is not.
Say this affirmation.
I'm not gonna forgive. They're gonna fucking pay.
Next time someone says, well, everybody's a little autistic, here's what you say. As an example, if they're taller than you, ask them how tall they are. When they answer, well, you know, I'm 6'5", then you answer, well, you know, everybody's 6'5". And automatically, their argument goes out the window. I've used it many times and it always works.
Let's talk the autism accent. Just a forewarning, this isn't a scientifically researched phrase. This is a catch-all term used to refer to a phenomena a lot of autistic people deal with. Being told you have an accent you realistically shouldn't have. And here are my personal observations as to what the autism accent may look like. A regular rate of speech, either too fast or too slow, and difficulty monitoring rate of speech. Smooth, flat voice with little to no inflection, and if inflection is included, it's typically in the wrong part of the sentence. Over-enunciation of every single word, because if this is not done, every sentence will sound slurred. Unusual, somewhat unconventional syllable stress. Excessive self-correction when speaking. Constantly restarting and revising your sentences if the wording isn't as precise as you'd like or they're not grammatically correct. And on a similar vein, extremely precise specific wording. According to a neurotypical friend I asked this question to, she claims that autistic people almost have a rhythm to their speech. And we also refrain from slang, but if we do use it, we often use it incorrectly. Autistic people also have a tendency to unconsciously mimic the accent of the person they're speaking to. And so a combination of all these factors leads to what people may perceive as irregular speech, an autism accent.
Do you ever worry that your entire personality is either just a trauma response or an ADHD or autism symptom, or is that just me?
My mom picked up a can of Evie Off Foaming Hair Removal Spray by Completely Bare, and I had to give it a test to see if this was a good spoony hack. I feel like my legs were the perfect test because, as you can tell, I don't really shave. As a Sicilian woman, I used to be very insecure about my dark body hair on my light skin. But then I realized that the ableist society is the reason we feel insecure about these little natural parts of us. So I keep my body hair to live in direct rebellion of it. I can't lie, I was shook to see how well this works. Like, look at that thing! I kept the foam on my legs for 10 minutes and I used a washcloth with water to wipe it off. I was really blown away because normally a lot of cream removers will burn my skin, but this left no burns and it just took away the very thick, coarse hair. One of the best parts was that it didn't have a strong, pungent smell. While body hair is a very natural part of us, I'm still pretty impressed with this spoony hack.
This trend absolutely hurts my heart and it makes me want to cry because I say such mean things about myself when I was a child because I was the weird kid. And I say, I can see why nobody liked me. Why would I do that? Why would I be part of the people that would hurt younger me? I was literally just a child just trying to make it through the world and it's just, I didn't deserve that much hate from nobody, not even my older self. Can you imagine thinking that when I grow up my older self is going to hate me? That's terrible.
Spirits in my head and they won't go.
I got guns in my head and they won't go.
Spirits in my head and they won't go.
I got guns in my head and they won't go.
Spirits in my head and they won't go.
I got